Hello everyone, welcome aboard Submarine BECUNA here at Independence Seaport Museum in Philadelphia. My name is Greg, and on today's video, we'll be taking a look at BECUNA's hydraulic system, how it functions, and why it's so important for the submarine's operation as a whole. This is Subscience. Hydraulics is defined in the context of engineering as the application of pressure to an enclosed or confined liquid in order to transmit power through that liquid, and the harnessing of that power in order to do useful work. The practical application of hydraulics on submarines depends on Pascal's law, which states that a pressure applied to a confined liquid is transmitted in all directions undiminished throughout that liquid. Early submarines relied on the manpower of their crew in order to complete many of the tasks BECUNA performed via hydraulics. But manpower has some obvious shortcomings, notably the physical capacity of an operator, and in the case of continuous operation, the stamina and fatigue of that operator. As the submarine developed, manpower was eventually replaced with electrical power, and in some cases even compressed air or pneumatic power. While these erased the problems that manpower posed, they did not come without their own problems. The compressibility of air meant that using it in a pneumatic system made starting, stopping, or operating that system with any finesse nearly impossible. On top of that, it increased the need for air tanks in which to store the compressed air, and the maintenance need for air compressors made such pneumatic systems unfavorable. Likewise, electricity possessed many disadvantages that restricted its use as a main power supply. Large amounts of power required the use of heavy and complex motors, generators, and controls, taking up space on a submarine where space already came at a premium. The maintenance and upkeep of such complex machinery also required dedicated technicians who would fill valuable crew spots. And just like pneumatics, operating large machinery with any amount of accuracy proved difficult at best. All this on top of the inherent risk of putting such large electrical systems on a boat designed to submerge completely. A hydraulic system, by comparison, requires machinery that is relatively light. The system is self-lubricating, reducing wear and tear and removing the need for dedicated technicians to perform maintenance. It is also fairly quiet in operation, which is important for a submarine that relies on stealth and secrecy to be effective. And it allows for precise control with the application of pressure. BECUNA uses hydraulics to perform a wide range of tasks, including raising her periscopes, operating her dive planes, and turning her rudder. This experiment will give you a basic idea of how a hydraulic system functions. The supplies you will need to perform this are two empty syringes, some flexible tubing, and some water. The first thing you're going to do is attach one side of your rubber tubing to one of your syringes. Make sure the plunger for the syringe is depressed fully when you do this, because the next step is to take the other side of your tubing and put it in the water. You're then going to draw back on your syringe and pull some water into the cavity. We've added some blue food coloring to our water so we can see it better. Once you've done that, the next step is to attach the free end of the tube to your second syringe. Again, make sure the plunger is down, otherwise your hydraulic system won't work properly. If you want to use some tape to help secure the tubing to the syringes or prevent any leaks, go ahead and do that now as well. Now all that's left is to try out the system you've created. Press down on the extended plunger and watch as the pressure you apply is transferred through the water and into the opposite plunger, pushing it up. This is the basic principle that allows a hydraulic system to work. Well, that does it for this video. If you enjoyed it, let us know by liking and sharing it. Then head down to the comment section and give us suggestions on topics you'd like to see us cover in the future. As always, thank you for watching. We'll see you next time.